All right, class, today we're learning parts of the boat. So on your boat, every part of the boat has a certain like term that we use to identify it. Like if you were having, you were on a car, you'd have the wheel, right?
Yeah.
So it's kind of like that. So this is important for you guys to know, because if you don't know your parts of the boat, then it's gonna be really hard for us to tell you instructions really quick, because we would have to tell you what we're doing instead of say, like just saying things. So like Addie, if I said move to port, what would you do?
I don't know.
Yeah, that's bad. What about you, Michelle? What would you do?
I'd sit there.
So that's bad because so that's bad because if there's an emergency happening and I say move to port and you don't know what to do, then you might die.
Oh.
So the parts of the boat, here we have a side view of it and a top view of the boat. So I'm gonna go over all the parts of the boat that you can see from here. So the first parts of the boat we're going over are the different directions on your boat. So there's
okay.
Four directions on your boat. Do any, either of you know what they are?
Right, left, up and down.
So kind of, but we have special terms. So on your boat, you have bow,
yeah,
stern, port, and starboard, okay?
Yeah.
So bow is the front of the boat. Stern is the back of the boat.
Okay.
Port is left, starboard is right.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So do you guys want to repeat that?
Port is left, starboard is right.
Bow is front.
And stern is back.
Yes. Nice job. Okay, so the next parts of the boat we're going to go over are the parts on here. So first off, what is here? Does that, do they know the name of this?
No.
Okay, so here, this is called the hull of the boat. So it just kind of means the boat itself. Like, this is the hull here.
Okay.
That's simple, right? So on your hull, you have a few terms you need to know. Daggerboard, hiking strap, tiller, tiller extension, rudder, mast. Those are the ones you need to know. So we're gonna start with daggerboard.
Yeah.
So daggerboard is this little, like, kind of like board sticking out of the bottom of your boat.
No, I don't think so.
Do you guys know what that does?
It's what makes it go in a certain direction, like a rudder?
Kind of, but I mean, I'm glad you know what a rudder does, but that's not what the daggerboard does. So the daggerboard keeps your boat from tipping and from drifting. So when you're sailing along, it keeps, if there's a current, it keeps your boat from drifting with the current, and it keeps your boat from tipping over really easily. You don't want to tip over because that's dangerous.
Is it
kind of
funny though when someone
touches? Yeah, it's kind of funny, but it's also dangerous.
Okay.
So the next one we're doing is hiking strap.
Yeah.
So sometimes, even with the dagger board, your boat's still gonna start tipping over. It's if there's really high winds. So what you wanna do is you're gonna wanna lean back in your boat to keep the balance, right? But you might fall out. So we have the hiking strap to keep you from falling out. So what you do with the hiking strap is you put your feet under the hiking strap and then you lean out and it keeps you from like falling out of the boat. It's very important because you don't want to fall out of the boat, because that is also dangerous.
Yeah.
Okay, next we have this tiller and tiller extension.
Okay.
So do you guys know what the difference between those two things are?
No.
Okay, yes. But so on tiller and tiller extension are both attached to your rudder. So basically the rudder is what steers your boat back
okay.
and forth, right? Like
yeah.
a steering wheel kind of. And attached to your rudder is your tiller, and attached to your tiller is your tiller extension. So the tiller is kind of this piece of wood in the rudder to use to steer it, right? And the tiller extension is just an extension of it, so it's attached to the tiller to make sure you can get it from farther away, or you can have like move it better, stuff like that. So, ready?
Yeah.
What's this?
The tiller.
Yeah, and what's this?
Yeah.
Okay, and what is this?
The rudder.
Yeah. All right, so that's good.
Yes, I know something. Now.
So next we're going over the mast. So the mast is basically this long pole here, long one here that your sail goes into. And the mast is kind of keeping your sail in place. It's what holds your sail up kind of so it doesn't fall over. So the mast is kind of just this long steel beam sticking out of the top of your boat.
Okay.
Yeah. And attached to your mast is your sail. So the sail is what you use, you know, to move. So the sail is used basically, it's the big triangle on your boat that you use to move the boat and to catch wind and stuff so that you can move. All right. So we have mast and sail, but there's one more thing. Either you know what this is.
It's a pole.
It is a pole, but it has a name.
Boom?
Yes, actually. It is called the boom.
Do you wanna know how I know that?
Why?
One time at camp, a girl got hit in the face by a boom and she bled.
Yep, that's how it's usually remembered at. People people call it the boom because that's the sound it makes if it hits you in the head.
Ooh, that would hurt.
Because it's hollow, so it makes kind of a boom. So
okay.
The boom keeps your sail outwards. So like, this keeps your sail from the mast to the end to keep your sail extended so that it can catch as much wind as possible. Last words we're going over are the wind indicator and the tow line. You don't need these ones to sail as much as you need all the other parts we've gone over, but they're important to have on your boat because they can help you go faster or help you in a state of emergency. So first we have the wind indicator. Does anyone want to guess what the wind indicator does? James?
It indicates where the current is going.
No. Michelle, do you want to try?
Like the direction of the wind?
Yes.
Oh!
Really?
Wow.
So
it kind of makes sense.
The wind works with, the wind indicator works by using different kinds of winds hitting your boat to tell you where the wind is coming from. So it can help you tell if what, like where your sail should be, what point of sail you're in, stuff like that. Going over is called the tow line. Do either of you want to guess what the tow line is? James?
It catches fishes.
It doesn't catch fishes. Michelle, do you want to guess?
No.
No? Okay, so the tow line, if you think about the name, it's a line that tows you. So it's used during an emergency. Say someone hits your boat and there's a big crash and you're sinking, that's bad, right? Or so there was a big hole in your sail and you couldn't move or anything. We use the tow line to tow you in, so we can pull you in so you can stay safe because obviously you can't just sit out there and you also can't sail. Okay, ready. Now that we've gone over all the parts of the boat, in front of you, you both have a diagram to label of all the parts of the boat. So we're gonna make it a little competition. So, you have about 15 cards there. Each of them has a label on here. The first one to label all your parts correctly wins candy. Yeah.
Dude, I'm so scared.
All right, guys, flashcards down. I'll tell you when to start.
Okay, sorry. Upside down or just there?
Start. Okay. On your marks, get set, go.
Okay.
That's a little boat.
Can I actually have some help in figuring out which one's which?
Yeah.
I don't remember. Which one's star and which one's port?
Okay. That's gonna be up cut out. So, you guys having a little trouble?
There's only like one part that I'm not sure about, and that's which one's star and which one's port.
Okay. So, good thing to remember left is port, is to remember left and port have the same amount of letters, right?
Oh.
So left is port, which makes starboard right.
Okay.
Okay.
What's this? I don't know. James, I need help. What's all? They're not, whatever. What?
Alright, so.
What if we just threw it away?
No.
Oh, that's.
You can't do that.
Okay, done.
Alright. James thinks he has it. Alright, let's check James.
Here's your haul.
So, sail, mast, wind indicator, hiking strap, haul, tiller extension, check. Tiller, check. Rudder, boom. Port, starboard, bow, stern, daggerboard, haul, tow line. James has it.
Yay!
Oh, that's all right, Michelle. You're really
close.
Okay.
I was
really close.
I just didn't know where that was.
Remember.
The hull has what on it?
I don't know.
The hull is what holds your boat together, okay?
Okay.
So the hull is actually the boat right here. This is the hull. Right there.
I was close.
Okay? Alright.
Well, this was technical. Yeah, I was close.
Alright, guys. Now that we've gone over all the parts of the boat, I have two questions to ask you. First, is there any good way to remember any of the parts of the boat? James?
Know them.
Yes, but if you didn't know them, what's a good way to remember port?
Memorize them.
No, like four letters, so it's left.
Oh, yeah, right, yeah, right.
Yeah, so that's a good way to remember port. Left and port have the same amount of letters, okay? But other things, like, say, the dagger board. How would you remember the dagger board?
It looks like a dagger.
That's true, yeah. Michelle, how would you remember something on here?
I don't know.
Okay.
Like, so, I don't know, I think, like, tiller and, like, tiller extension, like, they go together, right? So, like, mm-hmm. I don't know.
All right, guys, maybe so one question. How do you remember what this is called?
The boom?
Yes. How do you remember that name?
When someone gets hit, it makes, like, a boom.
Yes. When someone gets hit, that makes a boom.
Right.
All right. Other questions.
That's horrible.
The last question I have to ask is, why is it important we know this?
Who cares?
For safety, like.
For safety.
But I mean, like, on the rocks we go on a boat.
But like, if someone like tells you, if you go on a boat and like someone says, go to port, and you don't know where it is.
Oh,
like,
okay. Okay. So the reason this is important to learn is A, safety reasons. Nice job, Michelle. Two is for racing instructions. It's just a convenient way to say things, like say, grab, like, hold on to the hull, pipe with the strap, stuff like that. It would be a lot more difficult to say if you didn't know all the terms. All right, so you guys had a fun lesson?
Yeah, I did.
All right.
Yay.
Yay. All right, you actually learned something?
Wait, can we all laugh in here to make that audience laughter noise?
We're not testing it out. I learned
one question.